village to raise a child, what if a whole community raised a child? What would that look like? How could we foster that to happen, and how that would make a difference? We know that healthy children come from attachments to healthy, caring adults. A child requires nurturance and limits in order to become a happy, adaptive individual. Parents, grandparents, other caregivers, teachers, neighbors, friends are all these caring adults who provide nurturance and limits for children. This world needs sunny copers. This slide helps picture the power of nurturance and limits. With lots of love, encouragement, coupled with structure, some rules and understanding and boundaries, kids flourish. We want happy, well-adjusted children and youth. They grow up to be happy, caring adults. Picture this, a young couple in relationship becomes pregnant. Even with the best of intents, their relationship cannot handle the pressures. Difficulty getting gainful employment, handling expenses, all challenges. There is a level of stress that is helpful. Everything was smooth, we would not build the skills to manage in times of trouble. A certain amount of adversity helps to build character and increase our ability to cope and change. You can see the positive attachment that this child feels toward that caring adult, and it will only be a short time before that child will want to explore their world. And every passing day, that child is getting training on whether the world is a safe or a dangerous place. Formal supports are those services that we count on to help us manage life's various challenges and problems. Formal supports offered at the right time can make a huge difference. And then there are informal supports, extended family, church, friends. We all need a shoulder to lean on when faced with challenges. With support, we feel loved and gain the security we will be able to manage. Supports, both formal and informal, help caring adults move through difficulties. How many times have you seen a child who appears lost? As caring adults, when we create relationship with one another, we build the capacity to take action to help a child who's lost. The power of supervision is a kind of limit. The caring adult gives space to allow safe exploration and can step in when there's danger. These kids look happy. There's a place for everyone. When children feel a sense of belonging, they are able to explore through play. Presumably, they're being supervised by a caregiver. Put yourself in this youth's place. He is alone, perhaps waiting his turn, or perhaps feeling very isolated and not welcome. A caring adult, as a volunteer coach, can ensure he's included. And look at the sense of pride this young person feels. A level of self-confidence and self-worth has been possible because of the caring he's received growing up. Every age and stage requires some adjustment to the way we provide that warm, safe place. And in adolescence, youth can push the limits and many factors to challenge the parent-child relationship. Sometimes youth reach out to other troubled youth, in spite of a loving family. The fact that a youth may not welcome the actions of a caring adult doesn't mean that they don't benefit from it. The opportunity to work with others and contribute to community builds community. Cared for children and youth become caring adults, a collection of sunny copers. So the level of nurturance and the level of limits makes a difference. Each child is unique, so what one needs may differ from the other. What matters is that we are paying close attention to how the child responds to us when we give those limits and we gauge our response. The way we create nurturance fosters the level of our emotional health or sunniness, and that can be done through formal and informal supports. The formal and informal ways we create safe environments foster the level of our ability to cope and adapt to change. Examples of formal supports include our police and services that offer a place of safety. Informal supports are things like rules and adult supervision in sport, neighbors and friends who are willing to listen. So what does it look like if a community raised a child? Community is a collection of caring adults that actively work to create warmth and safe places for children and youth to flourish. There is a rich combination of formal supports in our local community, systems that work collaboratively to respond to needs, and here in Perth Centre is proud to play a part in that by supporting caring adults to meet the mental health needs of kids birth to 18. How we treat our children and youth is a reflection of their worth and makes a statement about what we value. Our children are counting on us to care for them. When we do this at home, in our schools, in our neighborhoods and communities, we're all a part of raising healthy children. Thanks.